Hello everyone and welcome back to Azure Wala YouTube channel. Today we will solve two questions and understand their fundamental behind that. So let's start. First we will understand the concept and then we will see the questions. So first thing is the definitions. We have three definitions in front of us and we will understand. So we are talking here about availability set. So that is a logical grouping of virtual machines that is called availability set, which is, you know, correlated. Failure brings down a related virtual machine at same time. So it reduces the failure of virtual machines together. That is called availability set. The second one is Faultdomain. Faultdomain is a group of virtual machines. Okay, they share common power supply and network switch, so that's easy to remember. And what is Updatedomain? Updatedomain is the group of virtual machines again, underlying physical hardware. So virtual machines as well as underlying physical hardware that can be rebooted at same time for any maintenance activity. So is the virtual machines plus underlying hardwares sometime needs to be rebooted together. So this group is called Updatedomain. So now let's see in the diagram how we can further understand by the diagram. So for example, if we do have one data center and we do have multiple racks there where all the servers or multiple servers are, you know, under these racks. So for example, this one is a rack, rack 1 or Faultdomain 1, and this Faultdomain 1 is having multiple servers or host machines inside. So on that host machine we do have virtual machines running on them. So a server is like, you know, or the rack is like a vertical stack of the servers or host machines. We may call it like Faultdomain 1. Similarly, another rack which is having multiple servers or host machines, or we can call it node as well, multiple nodes in Faultdomain 2 and similarly Faultdomain 3. So this is the physically these racks are connected with individual power supply or the power source, and it may happen that sometime maybe the power outages due to this power supply failure or maybe the network switch. So that's why this is called Faultdomain. The second one is also having the same, and third one the same. Now Updatedomain. So this is a like logical grouping of virtual machines running on different nodes. So for example, if we consider, I'll clean this up quickly. Okay, so for example, if we segregate virtual machines from this Faultdomain and another one, and three of three together, we club it together because this is logical group. So whenever we do have any update going on, we can reboot these virtual machines together. Generally there are, you know, two virtual machines out from the three racks. So for example, if these virtual machines need to be started, you know, so that virtual machine can start its along with its underlying hardware. This virtual machine and its node, for example, can be started together. So rest of the virtual machines will not get affected and it will keep running, you know. So it makes sure the availability. That's why we can call it availability set. So similarly, we have more and more update domains. So let's say Updatedomain 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 in this case. We can go up to 20 Updatedomains. Microsoft Azure allows 20 Updatedomains and 3 Faultdomains maximum number. These are the maximum number to remember actually for exam perspective. So the more Updatedomains, it means more availability of virtual machines. More and more number of virtual machines will remain available in the event of update, or in the event of driver update, etc., or maybe in the event of rack failure. So we just quickly understand, in case let's say for example rack 3 power supply is gone out, so these all virtual machines will get down. In that case, these set of machines will keep running and it will, you know, serve that application. Similarly, if we do have any update domain, for example, in update domain all these virtual machines and underlying hardware is starting, in that case other update domains and their virtual machines as well as their nodes will keep running. It means it will make sure that application is available and all the virtual machines not going on outage together. So that's the objective. I think I have cleared the concept. Let's move forward. So the question number 16 says your company has Azure subscription. You need to deploy a number of virtual machines using Azure Resource Manager templates. You have been informed that the virtual machines will be included in single availability set. So a single availability set is having multiple fault domains and update domains. This is what we understood from the last explanation. You are required to make sure that ARM template you configure allows as many VMs as possible. So the maximum number of VMs remain accessible in the event of fabric failure or maintenance. Which of the following is the value that you should configure for platform fault domain count property? So here we are talking about fault domain, and from the explanation you might have remember that that's the maximum number possible in Azure is 3 for the fault domain. So in answers given here, the number of fault domains cannot be 10 because that is not allowed. 30 is cannot be, and mean number it will not serve the solution in this case. So we are expecting that as many as VMs are possibly to remain accessible. So we have to go with the maximum value, which is 3 actually. So I think this is clear, and I will again at the end of this video I will show you in Azure portal as well that where how we can see these values. Question number 17 is similar, but it's asking another aspect of the same question, which is rest of the things are same, like as many as virtual machines possible remains accessible, okay, in the event of fabric failure. So up to this point the question is like the exact same like the previous one, but here what exactly it's asking. So here examiner, you know, will check that you read it carefully. So here it's asking platform update domain count. So in previous question it was like platform fault domain count. So it was asking about the fault domain, which was the maximum number 3. But if same we are asking in terms of update domain, that how many number of update domain are supported by Azure. So in that case maximum number of update domains we can configure for any availability set is 20. So the correct answer is 20. Rest of the things are incorrect. So now I will show you in Azure portal itself where you can make sense of that. So now I have opened the Azure portal and we'll look for the availability sets, and this is the availability set and this is the create screen. So we'll go here and create a new availability set. So first of all it will ask the subscription where you want to create, resource group and name of availability set. So let's say availability set 1, and yes, here the thing is I'll scroll it up. So let's go, for some reason scrolling is given up, so I will quickly make it visible. Okay, so here if we scroll it down we can see here that number of fault domains, in that case default number is 2, means 2 server racks you can consider having multiple servers in it. So if one server goes down, at least second server can act, and maximum allowed number is number 3. So we cannot make like 4 or 5 or 6, something like this. It will take maximum number 3 only. So maximum number supported in the fault domain is maximum number 3, and update domains maximum number, the default is 5 actually here, but maximum we can drag it up to 20 only. So the second question, if you remember, is maximum number to make update domains are 20. If you find my videos useful, please like the video or subscribe, and press bell notification icon, so I can make more and more useful, meaningful videos for you. And if you have any particular suggestion, you can post a comment and share with your friends. So thank you very much. See you in next video.